All right, howdy folks. Welcome back to the Taylor Burke Start of the Show series here on MLB 23 PS5, episode 366. Coming off what has to be the greatest episode we've ever had. Episode 365, one full year of Taylor Brooks. And if you missed it, go check it out, because we just won our first World Series in this career. 1 year later from starting this, we just won our first World Series. It was poetic. Taylor threw all nine innings. The offense came through huge in the sixth and seventh. And after that sixth, I was pretty confident. After that seventh, we had the World Series in our bag. It was just a matter of time. But yeah, what a run in the playoffs. Taylor goes 6-0 on 7 starts, 0.94 ERA, 57 and a third innings pitched, and 82 Ks over that span. 0.52 whip, and all 7 games he pitched were games we won. So it was a win versus Toronto. It was a win versus Cleveland, win versus Oakland, win versus Oakland, and a win versus Oakland, then two against the Giants. What a run. I'm extremely happy. But we have some decisions to make today, as in, are we going to be a Mariner for the coming time? I mean, that's the big one, really. This team right now has some older folks on it. We did our job. Okay, I want to look at the roster. My bad. We did our job, but Taylor is going to be 28. He's going to stay really good, but Chance is going to be 29, and he's going to move down a good bit. You've got some guys that are going to stay right around the same overall. Bullpen was never very good. A little bit of potential here with James Knapp, but who knows. Rene Pinto did end up getting hurt. I never actually checked that. I'm a terrible YouTuber. But we never really have... we don't really have a solid catcher right now. JT Schwartz, I believe, was on a one-year deal, but we've got him under team control for a bit at least, so we could use him a little longer. Bryson Stott is 34. He's getting older. What a legend he is. Bobby Turner's 32. He's also getting older. And then Gunnar Henderson is a 30-year-old at 96 overall. So Aaron Seo's 32. Petey's 30. Julio Rodriguez is 31. He's been regressing a lot lately. And then Vaughn Brown is 78. But I mean, who cares about Vaughn Brown? I think I have my plan in mind. I think I want to throw one more year with the Mariners. Like, we'll sign a one-year deal here in the offseason. But we'll see. From an awards standpoint, out in the NL, Nolan Gorman wins his first MVP, absolutely crushing the ball, 37 homers, 126 RBIs. The Cardinals cannot three-peat or whatever. Elliot Ramos was great as well, 41 homer year for him. And Buddy Kennedy, the first baseman for the Braves, looking like Freddie Freeman out there. Robbie Cosmo is your Cy Young. Owen White came in third. Wow. Robbie Cosmo, though, one of the pitchers for the Giants. Andrew Vaughn with the batting title. RJ Dabovich with the reliever of the year. None of these guys are young. Greg Baker is the rookie of the year, the starting pitcher. Another pitcher, Rodrigo Chavez, was close, as is Mariano Guillen, who is a first base prospect for the Braves. Could also play some third. We'll see. Buddy Kennedy's your Hank Aaron, and here are your Gold Gloves and Silver. Oh, let's check on Jackson Holliday, who's a 95. Had another really good year, living up to that. Oh, wow, this year was way better. An 8.6 WAR. Living up to that status that he needed to live up to with the Orioles. And then Drew Jones really played a lot better this year. 927 OPS. Contact went up 9 points versus lefties. He's really become a good hitter, which was where he severely lacked skills. But it's good to see. And here are Silver Sluggers. Jackson Holliday wins one. And your postseason MVP for the NL was Jordan Lawler, who had 5 homers and 14 RBIs. Over in the AL, don't worry, Taylor did not lose his MVP. He wins again for his, I believe, his 7th MVP. So, that's impressive. Riley Green is your 2nd place. Ellie De La Cruz comes in 3rd. For Cy Young, Taylor smoked him. The only close person was Max, who had himself a phenomenal year. He's got a good chance of being a Hall of Famer as well. Hunter Green is a good White Sox pitcher now. Batting title goes to Angel Molina, the potential right fielder for the Jays. Ryan Weathers is reliever of the year. Dave Pease is your rookie of the year. And Garrett Ward goes to Riley Green. We are not going to get a gold glove here. Cam Jackson does capture another gold glove, though. Stoddy comes in 2nd. And then Silver Sluggers are as follows. Cam gets back on top of Francisco Alvarez this year. Stoddy in 2nd for that as well. Max Muncy had an absurd year. Gunner comes in 3rd. Ellie also had an absurd year. Postseason MVP goes to Bryson Stott. He was phenomenal. Should have went to Taylor, all things considered, but Stottie's fine. And Stott also is your World Series MVP. So, that is how we wrap up the season. Taylor's going to be 27? No, he's going to be 28 years old next season. He's getting old, man. He's getting to be an old man. Our Hall of Fame potential is all the way there already. And as you can see, the World Series is right there, sitting right in front of you. So I love it. I'm happy with it. Taylor's at 161-61 on his career, 2,117 innings pitched, 2,857 Ks. So this coming year will be our 3K strikeout season. The lowest FIP of our career in this past season. So that's awesome. And I'm good to move on. Well, not our lowest component ERA, which was 0 in 2030. Anyways, let's get out there and let's get into this. In the offseason, viewing the retired players, we did finally get rid of Trey Turner, who he had a contract on, oddly. There's some other guys here. Austin Riley retires. He didn't get quite the fair shake. He actually stopped playing around 2029. That sucks. Lourdes Gurriel Jr. retires. Dansby Swanson, great career for the former number one overall pick. Kevin Biggio, Jake Berger, Dane Dunning, threw a good amount of innings. Ty France, almost 1,500 hits. No Hall of Famers this go around, looks like. No Hall of Famers. Matt Olson, 373 homers. Not quite at the level. JT might be in real life, but I don't think so. Even being the best catcher in the league for a few years. He was really good, though, all things considered. But I don't know about Hall of Fame. No Hall of Fame inductees this season. And we can send the offseason out.
They did it. They are World
I have music playing and no one can hear that, so just gonna turn that off. We have an offer coming from the Mariners for 9 years, $315 million. I'm cool with re-signing with the Mariners without looking at any other team. We'll just go 1 year, $35 million. Good 2-year player option.
2 years. Okay. We'll play 2 years with the Mariners. That's kind of what we owe them. So, it's 5 years with the Mariners in total. All is well, life is good. But you're still the number one pitcher, and Wild Chance is the four pitcher. So, okay, great. Let's go ahead and sim our spring training. I could care less about this. All right, we are 17 and 10 on the spring training. Let's check out. Let's just go and we'll have Taylor throw. Pretty good. All right, we're throwing opening day tomorrow. We've got. Okay, this isn't awful. Emerson's a decent 2. Walter Ford's a decent 3. Chance is going to be our 4, and all things considered, he didn't regress as much as I thought he was going to, so that's fine. We do not sign a relief pitcher. That's very concerning, is our lack of bullpen here. I do like the idea of Devin Williams coming over, though, but his last 3 seasons have been abysmal. Gilmore, okay, well, not the best offseason so far. Okay, hold on. We signed somebody. Oh, we also still have Cole Young. Did not think we were going to have him. 5.4, 1 year deal. That's not that deep. Okay, so oddly, so Pete Crow Armstrong doesn't regress. That's perfect. And then we have Brian Rocchio, who signs with us on a 4-year deal because that's exactly what we needed, another shortstop, right? He does hit decent, so I'll take that, and he could fill in at shortstop, and Gunner's going to ride the bench against lefties. Bobby Turner, Bryson Stott, still there. Huge. Well, Bobby got a little bit better, actually, and Bryson got a lot worse. That big regression from him and J-Rod. JT Schwartz stays awesome. Heston Kjerstad is a decent signing to play right field for us. Still no signing on a catcher. It'll be Renee Pinto for another year, basically. So, alright. What a strange, strange offseason. We were ranked 22nd. I don't see us doing too much this year, but I said that last year when we won the World Series. So, it's always an adventure with this team. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We've, at the minimum, got another 70 episodes with this Mariners team. So, that's kind of the agreement I wanted to make since we won a World Series with them. Give a little bit more of Taylor's time to this team. If you like the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. That's it for me. That's Taylor Brooks, episode 366 in the books.